So now on BBC Knowledge, a preview of tonight's film.
Directed by the Bhutanese writer-director Khyentse Norbu, The Cup is an utterly charming tale about a young group of monks living in exile in India who go football crazy in the summer of 1998, the year France played Brazil in the World Cup final. Cheeky 14-year-old protagonist Orguian is so mad for it he even wears a homemade version of the Brazilian striker Ronaldo's strip under his monk's robes. Risking expulsion from the monastery, he and his friends sneak out at night to watch the matches at a local shop. In some ways, the kids' hijinks put one in mind of a Bruges version of an old school movie, with all the stock characters you would expect in something like Tom Brown's School Days or Centrinians. There's the kindly but clueless principal, in this case the abbot, and the gruff head teacher, here disciplinarian Gecko. Based on a true story, it all ends happily when the monks pull their meager savings to hire a satellite dish and a black and white television from the local shop. When one boy complains he doesn't want to contribute, Orguian reminds him that Buddhists shouldn't be too attached to things. He may be cheeky, but his theology is impeccable. Norbu worked on Bertolucci's Little Buddha before making this, his debut film. All the actors were real monks without previous experience, and the director coaxes confident, naturalistic performances from them. But the actors deserve credit in their own right. Apparently, the dialogue was prompted and memorized on the spot, with most scenes completed within three takes, a testament to their monastic discipline and concentration. Other Himalayan-set movies like Kundun, Martin Scorsese's rapturous and symbolic epic, or Black Narcissus by Powell and Pressburger are notable for their lush artifice. In stark contrast, The Cup has a modest, restrained shooting style. Norbu evokes the ordinariness of these young, mischievous boys who like a kickabout, are fascinated with Western culture, and just happen to wear 2,500-year-old fashion. British critic Geoffrey McNab observed that underneath the film's exotic trappings, it's much like an evening comedy. By the end, the whole community has been drawn together to share in a common objective. It's an insider's view of monastic life. Norbu is himself a Buddhist lama and is recognized as the reincarnation of Jianyang Khyentse Wangpo, a religious reformer and saint who is revered for his part in protecting Buddhism in Tibet in the late 19th century. The film offers a strong anthropological interest as it shows the rituals the monks undergo, beautifully and respectfully shot, although Orguian, like any 14-year-old, often goofs off during the ceremonies, playing with his origami and passing notes. At the same time, there is a lightly rendered poignancy about these monks' lives in a mooted political subtext. The abbot longs to see again the homeland from which he's been exiled. The two young boys who arrive at the beginning have just made a dangerous journey, escaping the Chinese who patrol the border. When they meet the abbot, they discuss the poor quality of Chinese rice, a metonym for all that's been lost by Tibet's occupation. But The Cup avoids polemics and instead focuses on creating a warm-hearted fable in which East and West, television and hand shadows collide and coexist happily with each other. This is the first film ever to be made entirely in the Tibetan language. No nation could have asked for a better debut into the realm of international cinema.
Stay with us here on BBC Knowledge to see the film in all its glory next.